A busy calendar and a busy mind is going to destroy your ability to do great things in the world. You need to have a free calendar and you need to have a free mind. This is one of the quotes by Naval Ravikant. In this video, I'll just be talking about some ways with which you can become ultra productive or some ways with which you can manage your time much better. Now look, he also says this one thing, and that is be too busy to do coffee, but also have an uncluttered calendar, right? This is also one of his quotes. But basically, what I'll be talking about today is just going to be some ways with which you can better, you know, manage your life, manage your time. A lot of you will be asking me in the comments that how do I manage my time? How do I do all of the things that I'm doing right now? So I'll just be talking about that in this video. Okay, hit the like button because it is free and it helps me out a lot. Normally, when people say that, hey, I'm just too busy or I just don't have the time, the problem is that they do have the time, but they perceive other things in their life that are more valuable to them. So if you can change what you perceive to be more valuable, you will find yourself doing a lot of the work that you want to get done. It's not about how much work you are doing. It's not about how much meetings you are doing. It's not about, you know, working 12 hours every day. It's more about having that free time, having that free pockets of time that you can find in between your work, in which you can let your creativity run free, and that is how you can become a lot more productive. Okay, now let's try to understand what are the tools that I actually use. So I don't use like a lot of tools. I just have a very simple pen and paper. That's what I would use. I just, you know, pick up my notebook over here and I'll just start writing whatever I have to get done. Right, so that is what I would basically use. This is the first and the most important part. Another one that I use is going to be Keep, because it's super simple for me to use it and it is definitely a lot helpful. I just open it up, I put in whatever I need to get done. It's like a checkbox and I'll just keep checking them off whenever it is done. The third thing that I use is going to be Google Calendar. Okay, so with Google Calendar, what happens is that I can little like schedule everything out for my complete day. Okay, and I also like to plan ahead in time. What that means is that for my YouTube channel, I have planned out the next 15 videos that will be coming out. By the first of every single month, I make sure that I have the next few videos that I need to create. After that, let's also talk about my freelance work, right? So on Sundays of every single week, I make sure that I have the list of the videos that I need to make for my clients, some consultant work that I need to do. So I make sure that I'm scheduling everything on Sundays. This is the scheduling day for me. I schedule everything out. And how do I do that? I just, you know, open up my Google Calendar and I just put everything over there. Okay, now there is also this application called as Notion. Okay, so Notion is something a lot of YouTubers promote. I'm not promoting it. I'm just, you know, trying to understand if this would be useful for me. The way I use it is just to create like a list of work that I need to do. So I have like a Trello workspace in which I have a list of work that needs to get done. So it's like to do, in progress, and done. Okay, this is for done part. So I'm now able to, like, you know, get all the work that needs to be get done, and I can arrange it properly, and then I just transfer to the next part. This is sort of how I would work. I just make sure that I take my pen and paper and I schedule everything for the day, right? So I'll show you a screenshot over here, but basically you can just see what all do I work and how do I schedule everything. So let's take an example of 13th of March, right? So I have two podcast recordings. I have a meeting at 3 o'clock. Then I have an academy class and I have some more classes. So this is what I do. Okay, edit a video for my own channel. This is what I need to get done. I don't have a deadline that, okay, I'll be editing it between 4 o'clock to 5 o'clock. I just have a vague idea that, okay, I need to get this thing done by the end of this day. After that, I also need to make two videos for Geeks for Geeks. I don't have a deadline again for this, but I need to get it done by the end of the day. So that's also what I do. Again, let's take a look at 12th of March. You can see there's a lot of things over here. There's some video that I need to make. I also have the script for the video over here. Then after that, on 7th of March, I think you've already seen what happened on 7th of March. I vlogged the complete experience. It was a Sunday and a very busy one, actually. Just using a pen and paper, it has the best feeling, I would say, and that's what I generally like to use. Okay, so yeah, this is the script of today's video that you are seeing over here. But anyways, so that's how I would basically work on my task. Now, how can I manage college with this, right? So how do I manage college? A lot of you have been asking me this question. Because I am in BITS, I don't need to attend all the classes, right? So we have this rule called as the 0% attendance rule, because of which I don't attend all of the classes, or most of the classes, I should say. I do it because I feel that I have other important work to do. I perceive other work with more value, as I said in the beginning of this video. So I do understand that a lot of you do not have the same, you know, luxury to not attend any class in your college. You would have to do that. But then let's say you get free by 5 o'clock, okay? 5 p.m., you rest by up till 6 p.m., let's say, and then from 6 p.m., all the way up till 12 a.m. or maybe like 11 p.m., whatever this is, you need to structureize what will you be doing in the next 5 hours, okay? And a lot of you, what happens is that spend too much time on your social media. So, you know, just scrolling on social media. And I am a content creator. I create a lot of content, but I only go on social media to just put it out there. I go to the platform, I post my content, and I'm done. That's all I really do. Okay, I'm not like, you know, checking it again and again, seeing what is happening, what other people are doing, scrolling and all that. I don't do any of that stuff, because what happens is that you cannot have a lot of context switching. So there's something called as context switching. Okay, so this is the problem with social media. There's just too much context switching happening at the same time. You need to make sure that you avoid this. Maybe have like one particular time in the day that, okay, you at about 7 o'clock in the night, you will just open it up for some time, you'll use it, and then you'll switch it off. With context switching, what happens is that you will never be able to focus on one particular thing for a long duration of time, and that is what costing you your, you know, biggest achievement that you would want to make, you know, growing your YouTube channel or getting that degree or getting better grades in whatever you are doing. This is what you need to fix. You need to fix the time that you spend on social media, the time that you spend doing random stuff that you haven't even planned out for. Now look, I have a lot of free time for the entire day, right? So I'll tell you what that means. Right now it's about what? It's about 11 p.m. or 11 a.m. Okay, I'll record this video. I'll put it out by about 1 p.m. I think you should be seeing the video by that time. After that, I have about 3 hours free. 3 hours from 1 to 4, I am completely free. I can do whatever I want to. And this is the time when I use it to learn something new, right? So recently I'm reading this book called Brands. I am reading this book, or I should say listening to it. You know, you should definitely be listening to books if you have a lot of work to do, because it saves a lot of your time. So I listen to the book whenever I'm free, and I make sure that I'm having a lot of free time in between the tasks that I need to get done. Okay, that's just what I want you to understand. Make sure that you have a lot of free time in your work that you are doing, and that would be really important. You can also use some techniques called as the Pomodoro technique, in which you just work for 25 minutes and you take a 5-minute rest. Okay, that's one thing that you can do. There are also other principles called as the 80-20 Pareto principle. That's also interesting. You can look at that as well. There is also this really important concept in which you create like a quadrant, okay? And you divide that into 4 segments. You write something like important, not important, urgent, not urgent, okay? So now you have this quadrant and start putting everything into it. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Don't worry too much about the applications that you can use to be productive. There is no application that can make you productive if you are not in the right frame of mind, if you don't know your priorities, if you spend too much time on social media, you know, wasting your time on random stuff like watching tons and tons of movies, videos on YouTube. So it's not going to work out for you probably. So you need to make sure that you protect your time, your free mind that you have, and then focus that on a few tasks. But that's pretty much it, guys. That's what I want you to understand about scheduling and managing your time. I hope this short session or video was helpful for all of you. If you have any other doubts, if you have any other questions, you can reach out to me on Instagram at ishansharma7390. I post there pretty much daily. But yeah, you can also subscribe to the channel, hit the like button if you have not already, ask some questions in the comments. I will see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.